QuickShow can take in external control from both MIDI devices like an Akai APC Mini and DMX consoles like Grandame 2. Both settings can be found under Settings. First, let's look at MIDI control. First, you have MIDI settings. Here you can select MIDI devices connected to your PC for input and output. Generally, for a MIDI controller like the APC Mini, you will select it for the input 1 and output 2. Once you have added your connected MIDI hardware, you can set it up in your MIDI shortcuts and your MIDI to live buttons. For MIDI shortcuts, you can use the Learn button to have QuickShow listen for the next MIDI trigger to assign it. Just click the button on the MIDI device to assign. This is also done inside MIDI to live control, where you can learn a button, fader, or knob for any of the parameters. Once you press OK in either of these windows, it will save what you did. If you use an APC Mini, we have a default map that will be loaded automatically for you, and you can edit using these windows just like any other MIDI device. You can check your MIDI input by going to Settings, MIDI, MIDI Monitor. This will list all your MIDI commands and inputs going into QuickShow. Now let's look at DMX control. For DMX control in QuickShow, you'll need an NTEC USB DMX device. Once it's plugged in and the drivers are installed, you can go to Settings, DMX Settings. Here you'll have the option to do DMX input or output, select input. From there you'll see COM ports, select them and try to connect to the DMX device. If you have multiple, just try them all until you see connected down at the bottom left. From there, you can go to the new DMX input settings tab, and you can see the DMX control profile for QuickShow. Here you can set the starting address for this profile, and the channels below will update so you can reference the channels here with your console. This profile is the FB3/QuickShow/Beyond16-channel mode profile found on most major consoles' profile libraries. If you don't see it, check out the support section of the Pangolin website to download the profiles for most major lighting consoles. From there, you can press OK, and lastly, we'll need to click the DMX In button to activate control of QuickShow from DMX. You can also check to see if you have DMX input by using the DMX In monitor, and go to View, Show DMX Monitor, which will appear at the bottom and show you what your raw DMX input looks like. Thank you for watching our Quick Hints video on MIDI settings and DMX settings inside of QuickShow. If you still need help, you can contact our support line by emailing support@pangolin.com, and we'll help you as soon as possible.